So ultimately, a bad fuse or a bad oxygen sensor are really the two main issues at hand here. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today I'm gonna be helping you diagnose and fix P0030 fault codes. A P0030 fault code is gonna read heater control circuit bank 1, sensor 1. While that isn't the most descriptive fault code, it ultimately relates to the oxygen sensors and more specifically the heater circuit that is located within the oxygen sensors. Now, oxygen sensors and heater circuits are slightly more technical topics, and so to understand what the problem is here so that we can better diagnose and fix the issue, let's go ahead and talk just briefly about oxygen sensors and the heater circuit components in oxygen sensors. And then from there, we'll go ahead and talk about common causes of a P0030, as well as give you a diagnostic step list that you can go ahead and follow through to determine what the issue is and fix the problem. So oxygen sensors, as the name suggests, read the amount of oxygen that is in the air, and they are located within your exhaust system. When we get this P0030 fault code, it says bank 1, sensor 1. Bank 1 refers to the side of the engine that has the number 1 cylinder on it. This is going to be common on your V-style engines where you've got one side and the second side of the engine that are separate. You're going to have two oxygen sensors, and so bank 1 and bank 2 just helps you differentiate, is it this one or is it this one? And then sensor 1 is going to refer to whether it's upstream or downstream. Like I mentioned, these are part of the exhaust system. They ultimately help measure emissions efficiency, and so what we have is one oxygen sensor that's located before the catalytic converter, and then we have another sensor located after the catalytic converter. And what we do is measure the amount of oxygen in the exhaust gas at the sensor before it goes through the catalytic converter and then after. And by comparing those two readings, we can ultimately tell how good or how efficient the catalytic converter was at cleaning that air. And so ultimately, these oxygen sensors are used to tell whether your catalytic converter is functioning properly or whether it's bad. These are also used to control some other things like air to fuel ratios. So when your oxygen sensor goes bad, you can have a number of problems with your engine, like rough idling, hesitant acceleration, decreased fuel economy, and a bunch of other things that make it feel like it's just not quite running right. And that could be because the engine is compensating for the bad reading it's getting from the oxygen sensor by either putting more or less fuel into the combustion chamber. So these sensors do something very simple, which is read the amount of oxygen in the air, but the way that that actually happens is rather complex. These sensors use a chemical reaction to test the air for how much oxygen is in it. And that chemical reaction doesn't take place until the temperatures are approximately 600 degrees Fahrenheit or higher. So the issue is when you first turn on your vehicle, your exhaust gas is not 600 degrees, so therefore your oxygen sensors aren't going to be working. And it's going to take a long time, and depending on how cold it is outside or what your vehicle or engine is, your exhaust gas temperatures might not get up to 600 degrees by themselves. Therefore, the oxygen sensors won't work. And so the oxygen sensors on the inside of them have a heater circuit or a heater coil that basically heats the sensor itself up to 600 degrees so that the sensor starts working regardless of the temperature of the exhaust gases. And this works from a 12 volt power supply. So within the wiring, there is a power wire, and that sends 12 volts or an electrical current to this heater circuit inside the oxygen sensor, and that's what heats it up. And so when we get a P0030 fault code, it means that we have an issue with the heater circuit within the oxygen sensor, and ultimately the oxygen sensor is not getting hot enough or up to the temperature that it needs to be at for this chemical reaction to take place. So that was a lot of information there on oxygen sensors and the internal technical makeup of them. But my whole point in walking you through that was to help explain the components that are at play so we know what could possibly be causing this P0030. And in this case, with the oxygen sensor, there's really only two things that could be causing this issue: power and voltage, or the oxygen sensor itself. But there are a few more possible causes at play here, and so let's just go ahead and talk about those quickly. The number one most common thing that causes this is a blown fuse. If you look at your fuse box diagrams, you'll usually see something that says HTR for heater, or O2 heater, or sometimes it says ENG, SENS for engine sensor. That is usually going to be the fuse for the heater circuit on the oxygen sensors. And so a lot of times the fuse just blows, and ultimately then that 12 volt current is not getting sent into the oxygen sensor, and therefore the heating circuit inside it doesn't work. So if it's not a bad fuse, you probably have an issue with the heater circuit inside the actual oxygen sensor. The other things that could be causing it is like a bad electrical ground, and that bad electrical ground could be coming from like a ground strap that's attached to the engine that's bad. But a lot of times, if that's the problem, you're going to have a bunch of other things going on with your vehicle that would let you know that, because both the power and the ground for this heater circuit typically come from the ECM. You could also have an issue with the wiring on the oxygen sensor, but the majority of oxygen sensors have fully integrated wiring, to where if something's wrong with the wiring, unless you're an electrical wizard, the easiest thing to do is just to replace the oxygen sensor. So ultimately, a bad fuse or a bad oxygen sensor are really the two main issues at hand here. When it comes to diagnostic steps here, number one, try clearing the code, see if it comes back. It's always a great first step to do, to see if it was a one-off issue or if it's an actual problem. If clearing the code doesn't do anything and it comes back, then the best step is to check your fuses to make sure it's not just a blown fuse. After you've checked your fuses, if your fuse is good for the heater, then ultimately you're just going to want to go ahead and replace the oxygen sensor. There are ways where you can test the voltage and the current to make sure that there's not an issue with the wiring versus the internal component of the sensor itself. But like I mentioned, a lot of times the wiring and the oxygen sensor are fully integrated, to where if there's an issue with the wiring, you can't just replace that small little piece of wiring unless you're going to custom work up some wiring to make that happen. And so ultimately, check the fuse. If not, replace the oxygen sensor. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our video on P0030 fault codes. I hope this was helpful in diagnosing and fixing the issue you have going on with your car. If you guys found any value in this video, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel for all the future diagnostic videos we have coming.